Happy Tomato Pizza. We got everything taken care of. The technical difficulties where we didn't have time to eat all that pizza, Darren. That's what the problem was. But, got that taken care of. Volleyball coach Darren McClure joins us. The Skyhawks going to the 2011 Ohio Valley Conference Championship Tournament. Coach, congratulations. The number three seed. Good job.
Thank you. I really appreciate it. The girls worked hard this year. And, you know, it would have been nice to be the two seed, but we jumped right in and were able to stay sharp and start playing against the six seed.
Before we look ahead to the tournament, tell us a little bit about the ebb and the flows of a season and what this year was like for your team.
It's been really challenging. We've had a lot of success this year and done some good things. I'm really proud of the girls and the team. You know, we hit a little stretch there after we started playing all the teams the second time around in the conference and, you know, had a little struggle, had a three-game slide, but we picked it back up and finished strong. So I was really proud because it was a really tight race going down the stretch in the conference from the second seed in the conference to like the eighth seed. There was only a separation of a game or two. So it was a lot of really good volleyball being played in the conference, a lot of parity.
One of those years.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So you are the numbers third seed in the tourney. You will play Thursday against Jacksonville State. How did we do against them this year, and what kind of team are they?
We beat them twice this year, and I was talking to Coach McMillan before we got on, and we had to play really good to beat them. So that's the way it's going to be in this tournament. All these teams, actually, I believe every seed has a chance to win this thing. Everybody's been playing really good as of late. Obviously, Moorhead, you know, has won the conference outright, only had one loss this year, but I believe anybody can win this.
Top two seeds get a bye, which is why you wanted to finish number two. Do you like that format? Is that a good thing?
I think it is. That's a reward for, you know, competing and finishing well in the regular season, so I think that's fair.
Moorhead State hosting, as you said, they finished first. How good are they?
They're pretty solid. They've been good the last few years. They've got some good young players. They only lose, I think, two players this year, so they're going to be good again over the next few years. But, you know, it's just a matter of competing and gaining confidence. That team's been good over the last few years, so I think they play with a little more confidence than maybe some of the other teams. But, you know, it all comes down to this tournament.
I know the answer to this. I'm going to ask you anyway. Is home floor advantage a big deal in volleyball?
You know, I was thinking about that today, talking to my assistant coach, and I said, you know, I'm honestly glad that it's kind of stressful leading up to, you know, leaving to go to the conference tournament. I'm really glad that we don't have to prepare for all the meetings and all that stuff. It's easy to say that because we're not hosting, but I think there's a lot of stress. Coach Canary and I talked about it a couple years ago when they hosted. There's a lot that goes on when you host, when you're the number one seed, so it's nice to just kind of go and play.
Distractions, I guess.
I think so, yeah. Yeah,
it's the little stuff that the fans never see that go on
right behind
the scenes. What's their facility like at Moorhead State?
Last year, you know, when the floods hit Nashville and that area, Moorhead got flooded really bad, and their gym was wiped out. So they got a new floor and new lighting and everything in there. So it's a lot better than it used to be. It's a volleyball-friendly facility for sure.
I didn't know that. So they were affected by the floods also.
Yeah, it was really bad. Their offices were flooded. Their locker rooms were flooded. So they had to redo everything in Weatherby Gym.
What do you need to do going into the three-day tournament?
I think that we just need to take it one day at a time. That's kind of our focus, and we actually have practice tonight. We're going to talk about that and, you know, just kind of focus on ourselves as individuals, focus on our task at hand, focus on just becoming, you know, we're going to talk about the number one, and I think that's important to us. One as in one game at a time, one as in let's try to improve our own statistics by one, and to just really put the focus on that and not look ahead or anything, because I think you get into trouble when you do that. Obviously, Jacksonville State, we've beaten them twice, but at the same time, they're a good team. They fought to get here. They were kind of down in the rankings and fought to get back. So, you know, we need to just focus on the immediate future. So
the different thing about volleyball as compared to the other sports is that it's a match.
Mm-hmm.
And a game is self-contained. And when that game is over, you've got to move on to the next game.
Right.
And it seems to me momentum is everything, but at the same time, and I was watching against Tennessee State the other night, even if you lose a close game, you can turn it around because
exactly.
It's a fresh start with every game.
You know, that match against Tennessee State you're talking about, we lost 27-25 in the third game.
Heartbreaker. And I thought right then, I don't like this because...
Mm-hmm. As the coach, I was feeling the same way because
yeah.
I was like, man, it would be really easy for us to shut down in the fourth. But we came back and played great in the fourth. So I think that's a testament to, you know, the success we've had. We've kind of been in some tough matches. We've been down 2-0 and come back and... You know, the girls were just not going to be denied, especially those seniors. I mean, those kids knew that was the last game they were going to be playing at Skyhawk Fieldhouse. So They really willed us in. It wasn't a pretty game the other night, but we won, so I'll take that.
Talk about our home floor, and I know it's over, but that was a special night, and it was a rocking crowd.
It was. It was great. I tell you, the other coaches, the other sports were there supporting us, and I'm really thankful for that. I personally think we have one of, if not the best, facilities for volleyball in the conference.
And you play in the field house.
And, you know, it's the crowd is right there on top of you. When you pack it out, like we had 700 or 800 fans there the other night, it feels like it's 1,200. And, you know, so I think it's a great venue. Maybe we should try hosting it in the near future.
do any of the other opposing coaches or players talk about coming to play us and what it's like?
Actually, Morehead State, when they were here, we had a really good crowd that night. And he talked to me after the game about how the fan support was awesome. He said, you should be really thankful for that because that creates a great environment for volleyball to be played in. You know, there are some gyms like Tennessee Tech. It's not really volleyball friendly because they're so far off the court. Eastern Kentucky is kind of the same way.
You're in their basketball gym?
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's
very far removed.
It's a lot different. Yeah. And, you know, you could put 300 people in there and it would feel like 20.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a lot different, I think, in our facility.
And even at the field house, we have a band. It's not the UTM band, but it's a fan section that plays music.
Right. And they have been really instrumental. Those guys have been really supportive this year. They'll come watch our practice. Like tonight when we practice at 7 o'clock, I'm sure they'll be there to watch us practice. They've been really nice and supporting of us this year, so we appreciate their support.
Have you gotten to know the guys?
A little bit, yeah. They've come by and talked about wanting to scrimmage against the girls and this and that. So, you know, I don't know if that's more of just wanting to be around the team or what, but they've been really good to us.
Volleyball is definitely their passion, though.
Exactly.
But it makes for a tremendous atmosphere, though.
Absolutely. And that's what Jamie Gordon, the head coach from Morehead State, said to me. He said, Darren, he said, you know, they were on our case, but that's what's neat about volleyball. When you have that type of support and, you know, that type of environment, you know, you should be really thankful. I think he actually even told the baseball team who was there that, you know, that we should be proud to have them as fans because that creates a great venue.
Oh, so. And I think it's one of the best spectator sports just because of the pace.
Yep. There's always something going on.
Mm-hmm.
So people need to give it a shot and try to understand it a little bit because these young ladies are just as much athletes as anybody else, you know?
You know, and watching the other night, it really seems that they sacrifice their body. You don't realize that when you think of volleyball as being a non-contact sport, but you're constantly diving and turning flips and doing whatever it takes to get the ball to the other side.
Yeah, it's very hard on their bodies, actually. We've got some girls that are kind of beat up a little bit right now, and we're just trying to, you know, make it through a little bit, rest them when we can, and just try to nurse those injuries a little bit.
You had the best regular season that the team has had going back to the Chris Rushing championship year.
Yeah, that was, you know, we were preseason ranked at the bottom of the conference, 10th, I think, and yeah, that was okay with us because I truly believe that we weren't going to finish there. People around the campus had asked me where we were going to finish, and I truly felt we were a top three or four team. And, you know, we finished third in the preseason, and, you know, all that matters now is that we finish, you know, on Saturday night, you know, at the end of the conference tournament. So we'll take it.
Did you have fun? Was it a fun year?
It was. It was. Julia and I were talking today, my assistant coach. It's been fun, but it has been kind of a long year too. You know, it's just no different than any other year. It just seems like, you know, there's a lot more when you're winning. You want to keep winning, and there's a lot more that goes in that gets involved with that. So it's been fun.
And your travel schedule is grueling.
Yes, it is, very much so. We were fortunate to host a tournament at the beginning of the year this year. So that helped break that up a little bit. We're hoping to do that again next year. And the dynamics of the conference are going to change a lot next year with Belmont coming in. We'll go to divisional schedule.
Okay.
So that'll be interesting. It will help eliminate a little bit of the travel in conference. So that'll be interesting.
What kind of program does Belmont have?
They're going to be pretty good. We played them this year, and we were up 2-0 against them, and they beat us in the fifth game. I think they'll come in top 3, 4, or 5 in the conference probably. I think they'll be one of those teams. They'll be competing for the top, you know, the conference, you know, making a tournament and stuff. So,
with the divisions, will it be split east-west or north-south?
Yes, sir.
East-west?
Yep.
So we're with Southeast and
we will
Murray,
be, yeah,
Austin
we'll
Peay.
Be with Eastern Illinois, SIUE, SEMO, us.
Jacksonville?
No, Jacksonville will be in the east.
Okay.
So I think it stops with Murray, and then everybody else is in the east.
Will
so.
They do that with other sports?
I'm not sure because, like soccer, not every school
True.
Supports soccer, you know, or has a soccer program, so it'll be a little different amongst other sports, I think.
Last thoughts, again, you play Thursday, and this is at 4:30 in Morehead against Jacksonville State. What are your travel plans?
We're going to leave at 2 o'clock on Wednesday. We have a meeting at 8 o'clock on Thursday morning, and then we have a practice time scheduled at 10 o'clock on Thursday to get ready for, you know, the game that night. So I anticipate us having a big crowd up there. We have a great parent following. We were, you know, we were on the road this weekend at Eastern Illinois, and we had as many fans there as they did.
Yeah.
So I anticipate that this weekend, and just really looking forward to getting these girls back in the conference tournament. This group of seniors took us when they were freshmen, so, and we haven't been back since then, so I'm excited to get back, and they're hungry to do some good things.
If you win Thursday, you play Friday at 4:30 against Tennessee State. You win that, you're in the championship. So basically, three wins and you're the champion.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. That's the goal.
It sounds easy.
Yeah, yeah. You know, it's like I was telling Kevin. We, you know, one at a time, and you know, put three together, and that's what we've done that before. You know, we go back to our first tournament of the year when we went to Mississippi State. I mean, that was a good quality weekend. We played really good volleyball there. We just kind of need to focus like that, I think, this weekend.
And now is when it matters.
Exactly. That's exactly right. Put everything aside. It's, you know, it's a shorter season now. So, and we just need to focus one game at a time and take care of business.
Always a pleasure. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Chris. I appreciate all the support.
Thank you. Volleyball team, again, will play Thursday in Moorhead State against the host school, Moorhead, if they make it to the championship game, possibly, because they're on the other side of the bracket. Here is the bracket. First round game, Southeast Missouri facing Eastern Kentucky. The winner gets Moorhead. The winner of that goes to the championship. And then in the bottom half of the bracket, UT Martin and Jacksonville State facing each other Thursday at 4:30. Winner plays Tennessee State. You advance to the championship if you win that. That's Saturday at 6. All of this can be seen at OVCSports.TV. Thanks to Coach Darren McCloy. We'll take a break. Our show continues with Coach Jason Simpson in a moment on the Skyhawk Talk radio program on the Skyhawk Sports Network.